I'm very good, thanks. I'm really happy to be here, talk a bit about dynamic pricing in the airline industry. It's a fascinating topic, I've got some insights to share about it, so let's start. Sure, I've been working for 10 years at Amadeus now. I'm a functional expert in R&D in a group called Airline Offer Optimization Product. So we develop products like revenue management, dynamic pricing, which the airline use to set the prices of the tickets they are selling. I really love this area because there is a lot of math involved of complex optimization algorithm, and that's really interesting. In general, working at Amadeus is really good for the teamwork, for the international environment. Every day we work with people across the globe, and that's all very inspiring to me. So airfares are computed based on a large number of factors. It's quite a complex process. So first, high level, you have the macroeconomic factors. So the airline are going to build the range of price they want for a given route, for a given product, so the type of cabins and so on. And of course, those prices will also be influenced by economic factors like the fuel cost, like the inflation. So this price range will be adjusted maybe every year or so. Then within this range, the price are going to vary a lot. And this is where Amadeus products like revenue management, like dynamic pricing come in to really adjust every day the price for each flight. And the driving logics behind this pricing will be typically the prediction of the level of demands, which will depend on the type of period, the seasons, how close you are to the departure or not, and the remaining capacity, of course. The less seats remaining, the higher the price. Some life factors, like typically the price of the competition, can also be included in products like dynamic pricing. Last, the airline ancillaries, so the these add-on products, like the checked bags, like the type of seats you want to buy, they are a growing source of revenue nowadays for the airlines. So of course, the level of price optimization, the sophistication has also gone up there, and they use similar techniques for all of those. Dynamically adjusting the price is not new. Since the deregulation of the airline fares, so in the 80s, the airlines have been working at optimizing their price to maximize the revenue. But for a long time, they were somehow limited by the distribution constraints, by the quality, the volume of data they could store to do so. And this is what is really being improved nowadays. We have new distribution capabilities, we have much better data platforms, and all of those really are the enablers of true dynamic pricing, so which is like much more sophisticated optimization tool. And why it matters so much for the airlines is that it's key to their revenue. With all products combined, so revenue management, dynamic pricing, we talk maybe about 10% of revenue increase, and this is really huge, especially in a low margin industry like the airlines. Amadeus helps the airlines storing all the tickets they have been selling in the past. And along with them, the context of the purchase, when it was booked, what kind of product was booked, and so on. So we're talking huge volumes of data here, which we're going to use to then train sophisticated pricing model. Generally, the first step will be to forecast the demand, to predict the willingness to pay of the customers, how many customers are going to arrive. And then once you get this, you can now produce an optimal price by comparing that, matching that to the remaining capacity. The less remaining capacity in the flight, obviously, the higher the price is going to be. Sure, very good question. To ensure dynamic pricing follows the privacy rule, the first thing to do is to anonymize everything, all the data that is stored and all the data that is used then to build the models in order to comply with regulation like the European General Data Protection Regulation. But it's not enough. We go beyond that because we want to ensure that the models which are constructed are not biased in any way. So we bake it in, we make it so they focus only on the context, meaning what you're looking for, the type of products, and not on who you are personally. This information, the personal data, airlines will use it to maybe push a given ancillary, so this kind of add-ons to you, or to give you a reward for your loyalty, or maybe to compensate you if you've been disrupted in the past, but not to tune the price. So increasing price based on cookies, based on your browsing history, it's something that we absolutely not do via these products. So dynamic pricing, you understood it, is first a way for the airlines to maximize their revenue. But how does it impact the traveler? Generally, it's going to tailor the prices and the products a bit more to the traveler's expectations. So typically, if I'm a budget-conscious traveler, but also flexible, meaning I'm ready to look for my trip quite in advance, I may be ready to swap my dates if it enables me to get better price, then dynamic pricing is good for me. I will have maybe more discount, I will have offers which are more tuned to what I'm looking for. Reversely, if I'm a business kind of travel and I'm quite strict as to the dates I need to travel, I'm booking quite late in the process, then yeah, definitely the price may be a bit higher. So overall, you can see it really as a way to tailor the price and the products which are offered a bit more to the market, providing everyone with the level of service they're expecting. So optimizing the revenue is definitely not the only goal for the airlines. They also want to make sure that this pricing strategy they have is suitable in the long run, meaning that for that they secure your loyalty. You want to fly again with them because you perceive them as proposing good price and they have a good brand image with you. For that, definitely dynamic pricing needs to be transparent, needs to be fair. It means that typically if two people are looking roughly at exactly the same travel solution, at the same dates, they need to get proposed the same price. Airlines also have scenarios. They open a new route, so they want to gain market share there. So they really have a lot of scenarios where they want to get more volume. And dynamic pricing is also a good tool for this because it can really tune this trade-off between revenue, between volume, and all of this ensuring that the price remains fair for the customer. Yeah, we've been actually very vocal with our partner Finnair about this. They've been actively using the dynamic pricing solution in the past year and a half. And first of all, we all learned a lot about how the solution works. But most importantly, we were able to really measure a very nice result, so 3% revenue increase. So again, it's really a big number in the airline industry. And this really helped position dynamic pricing as a key pillar of Finnair's ongoing retailing transformation. In general, Amadeus Nevio, which was launched last October, it's a name for Amadeus retailing product, has been really gaining a lot of attention and traction on the market with products like dynamic pricing at its heart. When it comes to dynamic pricing, actually demonstrating the value is very important because it's a new product, so we need to be able to show how valuable it is. And it is a lot more complex than what you may think. Because, for example, it's going to be activated on part of the network, so you have all those network effects coming in, you have some users from the airline which are working with the product but also changing its results. You have to work with a baseline pricing even without dynamic pricing, which is already very complex. So you have to factor in all of those into your measurement. So we've been working a lot on that. We've developed a measurement framework which draws some principles from A/B testing. So A/B testing is quite widely used. It's all about comparing two pricing strategies, but we adapted it for the constraint I mentioned earlier. And we also baked it quite heavily in the product by leveraging our unique position, our unique integration with the other products within Amadeus Nevio, because it enables us to basically really track a passenger all across, track the conversion, so really have a proper measurement if dynamic pricing is successful or not. And what we saw, on top of this revenue measurement of 3% I mentioned, is also impact on the volume. It did actually increase slightly the volume of passengers, which we are all happy about because, well, more passengers in the plane means greener flights, right? Less fuel basically consumed for each passenger. So it was a very nice thing to see.